the floor to the representative, Mr. Ricardo Calderon of the Asian Forest Cooperation Organization. You have the floor, sir.
Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Madam Chair. Good day, New York. Good morning from Seoul, South Korea. The Asian Forest Cooperation Organization and its 13 member parties and two observers recognize the cross-cutting nature of issues related to forests, a very important natural capital that has to be managed sustainably in order to address the current global crisis. Sustainable management of forests, or SFM, has evolved from the traditional timber harvesting notion of growth equals drain. In this global pandemic, and in order to build back better, the global community should optimize the sustainable management of forests for water to irrigate our farmlands and produce clean energy, for biodiversity and wildlife resources management in order to prevent the future zoonotic diseases, for carbon storage and removal, to sustain industrial production, and for ecotourism for the urban population, generating revenue to forest-dependent people. It should be emphasized that forests and forestry is not just a sector, but an activity and a process that could provide synergy and co-benefits to agriculture, like agroforestry, clean energy and sustainable flow of water, for farmlands, for food production, and to the private sector by greening the industry in mitigating their carbon emissions, sustaining industrial activity that employs millions of people worldwide. We believe that these messages should be communicated more widely and consistently across the sectors and regions. At the same time, we should be able to clearly demonstrate how SFM can contribute to build back better, the greener in the post-COVID pandemic. AFOCO and its 13 member parties and two observers will always be committed to these actions. Kamsahamnida.
I thank the representative of the Asian Forest Cooperation Organization.
Yes, the next speaker, I would like to give the floor, Asian Forest Cooperation Organization. Mr. Ricardo Calderon, Executive Director, floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you. On behalf of the Asian Forest Cooperation Organization, AFOCO would like to congratulate the United Nations Forum on Forests and its Bureau and the Secretariat for rightly assessing forest pathways towards the sustainable and inclusive development and timely establishing thematic priorities to push forward the implementation of the United Nations Strategy for Forests. This is anchored on significant high-level political platforms in order to ensure that actions in the sector can generate far-reaching impact to wider societies and ecosystems. The work of Asian Forest Cooperation Organization with 13 party members and two observers in Asia is highly relevant and aligned to the achievement of 6 global forest goals of the UN Strategy for Forests. Since 2013, AFOCO from its predecessor, the ASEAN Republic of Korea Forest Cooperation, has emerged as a forest organization in Asia that is implementing forest cooperation activities. In total, our portfolio comprises of 50 ongoing and completed projects with a combined worth of $62.7 million, including $27.7 million in cash and in-kind contribution from member countries. These projects come in the form of 20 country-specific projects and 30 in-country initiatives under 7 regional projects that are responding to the pressing national concern, 1, by way of initiating customized restoration and reforestation models, local livelihood improvement for forest-dependent communities, strengthening institutional capabilities and regional actions, and supporting research, development of climate adaptation approaches, introducing systematic management of forest-related disasters that correspondingly relevant to Global Forest Goals 1 to 3 and Global Forest Goals 4 to 6 in general. Mr. Chair, taking this opportunity, allow me to share a focused recent effort to galvanize greater cooperation across sectors and borders in revitalizing the most vulnerable terrestrial ecosystems, drylands and drought-prone areas. Our Landscape Partnership Asia, otherwise known as LPA, is an innovative and transformative partnership platform with an ambition to contribute to national and international targets on restoration of forests in drylands and drought-prone areas, initially covering 10 million hectares in Southeast Asia, South Asia, East Asia, and Central Asia, to be brought under integrated dryland and drought management by 2032. Through the LPA, with its founding partners, C4 ICRAP and the Global Evergreening Alliance, APOCO expects to build robust partnership amongst government, technical, implementing, funding, and community partners, more efficiently mobilize financial, human, and technical resources to achieve transformational change within the landscape, and deploy proven, scalable solutions. In the backdrop of the United Nations designated decade for ecosystems restoration, the LPA will be able to showcase a successful partnership that embraces all landscape sectors to generate transformative changes in reversing the trends of deforestation and forest degradation in the region. As an observer to the United Nations General Assembly, APOCO hopes to work closely with the United Nations Forum on Forests and other relevant processes under the United Nations to bolster contribution of forests to sustainable development. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Oh, once again, the same mistake. Apologize. Thank you very much, distinguished delegate of ASEAN Forest Cooperation Organization.
We'll move on to the ASEAN Forest Cooperation Organization. The representative of the ASEAN Forest Cooperation, Mr. Ricardo Calderon.
Thank you, Mr. Chair, Excellencies, distinguished delegates, ladies and gentlemen. The Asian Forest Cooperation Organization, or APOCO, is a treaty-based intergovernmental organization with 13 member parties to promote sustainable forest management to address the adverse impact of climate change. Since the initial preparatory phase under the ASEAN ROK Forest Cooperation Framework 2012-2016, and the transition period 2016-2018, APOCO has been forging partnership with various regional and international organizations to more efficiently mobilize necessary technical and financial resources to promote sustainable forest management in the region. Development of updated guidelines for forest landscape restoration in the tropics, in cooperation with International Tropical Timber Organization and other members of Collaborative Partnership on Forests, is one of the successful joint efforts mobilized to advance knowledge and capacities of practitioners and the policymakers in promoting forest landscape restoration practices on the ground. APOCO and its 13 member parties has also been supporting a number of cross-cutting initiatives in strengthening institutional capacities, diversifying resources, and promoting actions to bridge the gaps in promoting sustainable forest management in the region under its strategic plan 2019-2023. Our capacity development program are strategically focused to strengthen forestry institutions and enhance forest governance by training forest policymakers, technical forestry practitioners, and researchers in the forestry sector. The APOCO Science and Technology Exchange Program is an intensive training program at leading forestry science and technology institutions aimed at providing quality training to enhance knowledge and skills in specific fields of forestry by exposing them in training here in Republic of Korea research institutions. The APOCO Scholarship Program under the APOCO Landmark Program is implemented for the government officials from ASEAN member states to undertake graduate studies in the field of forestry in Republic of Korea with 21 beneficiary so far, and the program is still ongoing. We conducted global youth camps to orient primary and secondary schoolers on the importance of forests. So far, we have 1,532 students who had already availed of the program. Our fellowship program for government officials of member parties to work in the Secretariat for knowledge exchange, our regular training courses in our regional education and training center for core training areas in forest rehabilitation and reforestation, forest fire management and community forest management, project development and climate change mitigation and adaptation, specifically designed for frontline forestry personnel of our forest, of our member parties. We were able to train 6,305 participants in 63 training courses. Despite the current situation in our regional education and training center, our training program is still ongoing under the virtual mode. Mr. Chair, Excellencies, distinguished delegates, AFOCO has been granted observer status by the United Nations General Assembly during its 75th session last year, which allowed firm and solid base to contribute to many ongoing international processes under the United Nations, including the UN Forum on Forests. We will always remain committed to supporting our 13 member parties and to observers in implementing the United Nations Strategic Plan for Forests 2017-2030, as well as partnering with many other ongoing forest processes and international cooperation mechanisms to uphold sustainable forest management in pursuit of sustainable and inclusive future. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Give the floor to the Asian Forest Cooperation Organization, to be followed by the Amazon Cooperation Treaty Organization. Foko, you have the floor.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chair. Am I clear? Thank you. The Asian Forest Cooperation Organization and its 13 member parties and two observers recognize the value and importance of the submission and analysis of the country national reports in order to assess the progress towards the achievement of the global forests and their associated targets. We would like to compliment the efforts of the UNFF Secretariat in coming up with a flagship publication on progress towards achieving the global forest goals and targets that was successfully launched at the opening of the 16th session of the forum. We also recognize that the collaborative on the work of the Collaborative Partnership on Forests, we are spearheading in achieving Global Forest Goal 6, generating cooperation, coordination, and coherence on forest-related issues. In the absence of formal United Nations system-wide coordination mechanism, we firmly believe that a formal regional body like the Asian Forest Cooperation Organization, with a clear mandate of promoting sustainable forest management, can further these efforts towards Global Forest Goal 6 by bridging the gap between global processes and local actions. In particular, we see a great deal of needs and opportunities in enhancing the work of the forum in monitoring, assessment, and reporting the progress on the implementation of the United Nations Strategic Plan on Forests 2017-2030. Along this line, we would like to express our willingness to work with and be part of the forum and the network of the Collaborative Partnership on Forests in enhancing coordination and coherence on forest-related issues at the regional level. We would also like to take this opportunity to invite member parties in our side event after this very much important discussion. The side event will be held right after today's session under the title Improvement on Global Forest Goal Implementation, Streamlining Forest-Related Reporting and Developing Methodology for Measuring Performance in partnership with the National Institute of Forest Science of the Korea Forest Service, Republic of Korea. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much to the representative of AFOCO.